If you're an entrepreneur, if you're a salesperson, if you are responsible for making revenue happen in your business, you do what conventional wisdom says. You're working on the questions you ask. You're making sure your presentation is better. There's no typos. It's well designed, all of these things. Meanwhile, you're ignoring the thing that will actually help you increase sales. Sales is not about the agenda or the presentation or the flipbook or design. It's about putting yourself in a position where you can actually influence change. And so amazing presentations may help, but that's not where you should be focusing your time. You should be focusing your time on putting yourself in a position where you can actually influence change. It comes in the questions that they're asking you. How do you handle those questions? You know, like I just got out of a meeting where if you're thinking about it from a traditional sense, a traditional point of view, I was underprepared. You know what? I love really tight, fancy presentations laid out in PowerPoint. We didn't have that. What I had was a tremendous amount of preparation put into what we were doing and why we were doing it and why it made sense to them. And so I had two choices. I was tight on time. I could spend my time laying everything out in a really great PowerPoint presentation that makes a ton of sense and that looks great, but be underprepared to explain what we're doing, why we're doing it, what the research says. You think that having the structure of a great agenda, of having a great presentation, you think that will make up for the lack of the other things. And because sales is relationship-based, you don't want to do anything that hurts your credibility. But these other things aren't as important as you think. You know, I walk into the meeting, yeah, I've pulled my examples, but they're only screenshots sitting in a folder. We're running a marketing agency. We didn't even plug into their projector. Open up my laptop, turn my screen. Come closer, people. Come closer around. Here's what I had. I had an understanding of how I wanted to run the meeting, and then I could bob and weave if things were different. I opened up by explaining from an emotional and feeling point of view how we got to where we are today, what I'm hoping we're gonna walk through in the meeting. They wanna know that you understand, that you've already thought about this for them, that you have a recommendation, this is how I would go, this is what I would do. I have a lot of experience and this is what I found it to be. Bring storytelling into your sales meetings. Focus on what you're doing, why you're doing it, the thinking that went into it. But here's why you're not gonna do it. One, it's hard. It takes time. You can't walk into a meeting unprepared. You can't just pull out your template. You can't just say the same thing over and over again because everybody's a little different. It requires you to prepare. Two, you're worried that you can't react in the moment. You won't remember it. You're not good enough. You have to have your presentation. How are you gonna remember what you're talking about? So you need to get better at that. Three, you're worried that if you don't have that structure, people are gonna take you all kinds of different directions. I'm not ready to talk about the seventh step. We gotta go through 1 through 6. We have to follow the structure. And lastly, you're worried that you're just not good enough. Without that presentation that people are bored of and falling asleep in, without the proven technique, you're worried that you're just not good enough. But having worked with hundreds, like maybe even thousands of entrepreneurs, here's what I can tell you. Jump out of that airplane without the parachute. Your brain will give you the answer you need in real time if you demand of it. You have this. You don't need the presentation. You don't need the fake stuff. You need to put the time in. You need to come up with the answers that you're proud of, whether they buy into it or not. You have to believe that what you're saying is the truth, and then you just gotta do it. Growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you. Be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.